Hey, Annie, where are we today?
Well, we are in the original garage building, building number two, as some people call it.
Oh, and we're here with this lovely red-haired chap. What's his name?
Jonathan Jones.
Jonathan Jones is gorgeous. He's an original Len Ensel walking figure. That's why he's so tall, right?
Yes.
So how did WS come to acquire Jonathan Jones?
Well, he was used just for 1 year by a young ventriloquist named Finn Bjornsson, who was from Sweden. He ordered him in 1952, ended up getting him in 1953, but in 54, that was a quick turnaround, he went off to school and said to WS, I don't think I'm going to use him again, and so he sold him.
He decided he wouldn't use him again in spite of the fact that he was so excited when he ordered him that this was going to be the most expensive ventriloquist dummy ever delivered inside Sweden, according to Finn. But he is very cool. He has a number of animations. He was custom ordered, naturally, and I'm going to take the head out here and show you the animations. You'll notice there's a pneumatic tube coming out of the body. There's actually a couple more, and I'll explain that in a moment. He's got the standard moving mouth and upper lip, if I can find it. And inside, when we zoom in, you'll be able to see there is a smoking mechanism inside. The cool thing about the interior of the mouth is the teeth. What's special about those?
Those are porcelain.
They are porcelain, which begs the question, why is there a smoker in there? Because all that's going to do is turn those porcelain teeth brown. Just saying. Anyway, this is also one of the few Ensel figures that came with eyes that move side to side. They move both sides. Most Ensel figures, they only look toward the ventriloquist. And of course, there are two winkers. You'll notice one's a little droopy. It was that way when WS got it. And of course, WS being WS, he wasn't too happy about that because Finn had said, hey, this figure's only a year old. But other than that, the pneumatic tubing, there are three fittings for the tubes. Those control the lower lip, the upper lip, and the smoker. And there's a lot of tubing in there. I would say Finn could probably literally control this figure from off stage.
Okay.
And what else is special about him? We mentioned that before.
Well, he's a walking figure, but it's very awkward. He does not walk easily.
And I kind of suspect that may be why Finn decided to go back to school and give up ventriloquism.
Oh.
It's just a thought. So let's see if we can make him walk.
Okay.
Okay.
Watching. If there's something you'd like to see behind the scenes, email Lisa at curator@benthaven.org.